Welcome to the deep dive. If you're dealing with peripheral arterial disease and, you know, looking for ways to maybe get a bit more active in managing your own health, this is definitely for you.
Yeah, we're going to explore something really key today. Exercise.
Right. And look, we get it, medical stuff, the science behind it, it can sound pretty complicated, maybe even a bit overwhelming. So our aim here is to really break down how exercise helps with this condition, focusing on what actually matters for you in a way that's, well, easy to understand and hopefully useful.
Exactly. And for this deep dive, we've been looking at materials from medical professionals, things like guides on the vascular system, discussions about potential issues and treatments, and the standard clinical guidelines doctors use.
Solid sources.
Definitely. So the mission today is pretty straightforward. Explain the role of planned, structured exercise in treating peripheral arterial disease simply and clearly.
Okay, let's dive in. First things first, peripheral arterial disease. We hear the name, but what does it actually mean? What's happening inside the body?
So, peripheral arterial disease, often called PA, it's essentially about problems with the blood vessels that are outside your heart and brain.
Okay, the peripheral ones.
Right. And very often, for a lot of people, this means the arteries in their legs. These are the pipes carrying that crucial oxygen-rich blood down to your leg muscles.
And how would someone, you know, start to notice this? Are there common signs?
Yeah, a really common one is feeling pain or maybe discomfort in your legs, specifically when you're walking.
Ah, okay.
It's often called claudication. We saw this come up in the materials, patients needing treatment, because this leg pain was really limiting how far they could walk comfortably.
So walking becomes painful.
It can, yes. And ultimately, when PA affects the legs, the big goal is always to try and improve the blood flow getting down to those muscles.
Right. So thinking about managing this, medications come to mind, maybe procedures. Where does something like exercise fit into that picture? Seems a bit different.
It might seem different, but exercise is actually a really fundamental part of managing PK. It often goes hand in hand with those other medical treatments you mentioned.
Right.
You can think of it as a way of helping your body help itself, boosting its natural ability to get blood circulating better.
Interesting. So it's more specific than just general fitness. How does just, well, moving my legs more actually help get more blood there if the arteries themselves have issues?
This is where it gets really cool. Biologically speaking, regular exercise can actually nudge your body to start growing new tiny blood vessels.
Really? Like little detours?
Exactly.
Right.
The term for it is angiogenesis. Some of the background science we looked at on how blood vessels work talked about how the physical forces, like the increased blood flow pushing through when you exercise, and certain natural chemicals in the body can actually trigger this growth.
Wow. Okay. So the body literally builds its own bypasses on a small scale.
Precisely. And that's not all. Exercise also helps the blood vessels you already have to become, well, more flexible and work better.
More flexible. How so?
Well, the vascular biology info we reviewed mentioned things like nitric oxide. It's a natural substance that helps blood vessels relax and widen. Physical activity seems to encourage these kinds of mechanisms.
So better flow through existing pipes, too.
You got it. Healthier, more adaptable pipes, basically. And there's another piece, too. Exercise helps improve the health of the actual inner lining of the blood vessels. It's called the endothelium.
That lining sounds important.
Oh, it's crucial. The sources we looked at really detailed its functions controlling blood flow, stopping harmful things from happening in the vessel wall. A healthy endothelium means much better circulation overall.
So exercise seems to be working on like multiple levels within the blood vessels themselves.
That's a great way to put it. It's hitting it from different angles. New pathways, more flexible existing ones, and a healthier inner lining.
And the end result?
The end result is that your leg muscles get a better supply of oxygen and nutrients. And that usually translates to less pain when you walk and being able to walk further before you feel that discomfort.
Okay, it's all sounding very positive. So if someone listening has PAD, what kind of exercise are we talking about? Is it like, go run a marathon?
No, definitely not. It's usually much more specific. We're talking about what doctors call structured exercise programs.
Structured exercise. What does that mean in practice?
Typically, it means regular walking sessions. Often it's done maybe on a treadmill or a flat track where you can control things. The key is that it's planned. You have a set amount of time, maybe a certain intensity level.
Okay, planned walking.
Exactly. The clinical guidelines often point to this structured walking as a really effective approach.
And what's the goal during these walks? Just walk as far as possible?
Not quite. A very common method, and one that seems to work well, is to walk until you start feeling that claudication pain or discomfort we mentioned.
Walk into the pain.
To the point where it starts, yes. Then you stop and rest just until the pain goes away.
Okay.
And then you start walking again. Repeat that cycle. Walk, rest, walk, rest.
That sounds counterintuitive, walking until it hurts.
It does seem that way, doesn't it? But this process, the cycle, actually seems to be what encourages the body to adapt and improve that blood flow over time. It gradually helps you increase the total distance and time you can walk without pain.
Huh. So it's a gentle push, rest, repeat kind of thing, finding that edge.
Exactly right. You're gently challenging the system, then letting it recover and repeating. Consistency is absolutely key.
Makes sense. Now, are there important things to keep in mind before someone just, you know, starts doing this?
Oh, absolutely. Crucially important. Before starting any new exercise program, especially with a condition like PAD, there's one vital first step.
Which is?
Talk to your doctor or your healthcare team. Seriously, this is non-negotiable.
Right. Get the green light first.
Yes. And more than that, they can help figure out a plan that's actually safe and effective for you specifically, because everyone's different, right? You might have other health issues they need to consider.
Good point. Personalized advice is key.
Totally. They can guide you on how much exercise, how often, how intense it should be. And really important too, listen to your body. Don't push through severe pain. This is meant to help, not hurt.
Right. It's a tool, not a torture device.
Exactly. And remember, exercise is usually one part of the overall picture.
You mean alongside other treatments?
Yeah. Very often it's part of a bigger plan that might also include medications to help with circulation or cholesterol, or sometimes even procedures to open up blocked arteries. They all work together.
Okay, that context is important. So let's sort of wrap this up. The big takeaway seems to be that a planned, structured exercise program, often walking, is a really valuable tool for people with peripheral arterial disease.
Absolutely. It's a way to actively participate in your treatment, helping your body improve blood flow naturally.
And the result can be genuinely better walking ability, less pain, just but a quality of life, potentially.
That's the goal. And it's not about becoming some kind of super athlete overnight. It's about consistent, guided activity.
So maybe a final thought for everyone listening. Just consider for a moment.
Mm-hmm.
How could taking these small, regular steps with exercise potentially lead to some significant improvements in your daily life, your mobility?
It's definitely worth thinking about. And we really encourage you, take this information, take these ideas, and have a chat with your doctor.
Yeah, ask them specifically, could a structured exercise program work for me?
Ask about what kind, how often, how hard you should push. Getting that personalized advice is the best next step you can take. It could really make a difference to your health and how you feel day to day.